Seriously, North Korea? Another underground nuclear test? You know we can see you, right? Hey, Hermit Kings and Queens, Trace here for DNews. So the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, aka North Korea, has reportedly tested their fifth nuclear device. They want us to know they did it, we know they want us to know they did it, and they know that they want us to know what we know. But how can we know it was a nuclear bomb? We're not just gonna take Kim Jong-un's word for it. There's actually an organization called the Preparatory Commission for the Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty Organization, or the CTBTO. Though technically I guess it should be called the PCCNTBTO. Since 1996, the CTBTO has had its ear to the ground around the world, listening for any rumblings. And that's not just a metaphor. They literally have 42 primary and 107 secondary stations around the world monitoring seismic activity. Usually they just pick up earthquakes, but if there's a nuclear test underground, like all the North Korean ones have been, they'll pick up the seismic waves through the Earth's crust and mantle. Based on the direction, speed, and type of waves each station picks up, the location of the test site can be deduced. But what if the tests are conducted underwater? That scenario has been planned for too, and the CTBTO has an array of 10 hydroacoustic monitoring stations globally. Why only 10? Because sound travels amazingly well underwater, particularly 1,000 meters down, at a depth known as the Sound Fixing and Ranging Channel, or SOFAR. With just a handful of stations, they can still hear nuclear tests in the Earth's oceans, even when they're so far away. Get it? And if the tests are conducted in the atmosphere, the CTBTO can catch that too. Again, the method is to use sound, this time at frequencies so low that we can't even hear them, or infrasound. These longer wavelengths travel farther, but they still don't move as efficiently as sound and water. So there are 49 infrasound stations in use right now to listen to the breeze. As a bonus, underground tests generate infrasound too, so the data can be combined with the seismographs for more accurate information. You'll notice all these methods of detection have something in common. They can be tripped by non-nuclear means. Volcanoes, earthquakes, and conventional explosions can cause seismic activity and sound waves. There's only one way for sure that you can know the bomb was an A-bomb, radioactive fallout. When a nuclear bomb explodes, it creates radioactive xenon isotopes. And because xenon is a gas, it can seep through layers of rock until it reaches the open air. This means that unless tests are conducted deep underwater or underground, the CTBTO can forensically prove when someone tests a nuclear bomb. So then what? Well, that's where the bulldog loses its teeth, I'm afraid. The Comprehensive Test Ban Treaty has been signed and ratified by 164 countries, but still needs 8 more before it can enter into force. Hence why the organization is still technically called the Preparatory Commission for the CTBTO. So currently, when a country sets off a bomb, all the rest of the world can really do is wag a finger at it and impose more sanctions for that test that was unsanctioned. North Korea, perhaps unsurprisingly, has not signed or ratified the treaty, but to be fair, the USA has signed it, but hasn't ratified it either. Still, until every country is on the same page about nuclear weapons, at least the CTBTO has the tools to warn the rest of the world that someone's not being chill. Guys, if you love DNews in English, gracias. Now we've got a new sister show, DNews en Español. It's DNews, but in Spanish. Check it out here.
Pero la manera en la que llegamos hasta aquí es absolutamente fascinante.
Los sistemas solares comienzan como una colección de gas y polvo girando a través del espacio. Eventualmente, el gas se desploma en el centro y a medida que surge la gravedad, una estrella como la nuestra se forma.
In early 2015, North Korea set off what they claimed was a hydrogen bomb. But was it? How is an H-bomb even different from an A-bomb? Julian covers it all here.
But A-bombs leave a lot of atomic fuel unsplit, which is where hydrogen bombs come in. An H-bomb detonation starts the same way an A-bomb does. Uranium-235 or plutonium is split, releasing tons of energy.
What's your stance on nuclear weapons? Inexcusable superweapon or necessary evil? Let us know in the comments. Make sure you subscribe so you get more DNews, and thanks for watching.